Well, hello everyone, and welcome to my new home here in Seattle. I'm excited to show you around. This is my favorite apartment that I've ever lived in terms of what I've achieved with decor and in terms of the view. So welcome and come on in. Just a little bit about this apartment. If you haven't seen my unfurnished tour, you should. It's kind of entertaining because it is the first time I ever set foot in this apartment, and it was a good surprise because as soon as you walk into the apartment, it feels very spacious and open, and I've tried to keep it that way in terms of how I've decorated and furnished it. So most of the furniture happens once you are already about a third of the way through the apartment or the main living area, and I've just kept the kitchen area and entrance area decorated with a few things, but not a lot of furniture going on because I wanted to maintain that feeling that I first had when I moved in. On that video, I saw some questions about the size of the apartment. I wasn't sure what the exact square footage was at that time, but now I can confirm it's 785 square feet, and I have measured to check that in terms of furniture placement. I haven't measured every wall, but I've measured most of them at one point or another in order to figure out where things would fit the best. So here at the entrance, just on my left, the antique coat rack, I guess this would be called, and I just keep some easy neutral cardigans on here as well as a scarf for easy reach. In the Pacific Northwest, you could be in July and still want a sleeve or something snuggly because it's actually raining outside right now. The handbag that I'm using at that moment, this is my evergreen scarf. If you do want a scarf from this collection, I'm down to my last few. I have two of the olive martini left and a couple of the evergreen and a couple of the blue as well. And then we are done with that collection. In the new collection, which is gonna be very different from any collection I've ever done before, is in production right now in Nepal by the family-owned business that I work with. So I cannot wait for that to arrive. And I'm gonna need to find somewhere to put all of my stock as well. So I've kind of organized everything to like a 90% extent in this apartment, and then a few things are gonna need to change over time. Let me show you a pan because whenever I watch home tours, I like to see what things look like generally before taking a closer look at individual items and moments throughout the apartment. So here is the room. And then I will take you through everything individually because I truly love every single item. Okay, so closer look, some of my favorite features in this kitchen other than the general U shape of it, which is super spacious. I'm on the fence about doing a rug. What do you guys think? Are you pro kitchen rug or con kitchen rug? Because I cook a lot, I've always felt like it would get dirty, but I could do a ruggable in there. What I've opted to do instead is I fell in love with the fun color combinations of this runner. So it was a really good deal. I got it from Wayfair, and I will link it as well as everything else that I show you in the info bar down below. So I love the double doors. I love the bottom freezer. I also love that it's magnetic, so I can actually put stuff on it. Christine from Ohio sent me the sweetest card, but it had no return address, so I couldn't write back. So Christine, if you are watching this, thank you. It's on my fridge. I love getting mail from you guys. I have my new Nespresso maker because unfortunately in storage, my DeLonghi Nespresso maker broke. So I had to get a new one, and I called my mom because I was so sad when I tried to make a coffee with it when I first got it back. I do really love the Vertuo system. She offered to get me this chrome one as my housewarming present, and I do really love it. I love the chrome finish of it. Of course, I've got my Le Creuset on display. Also, cabinets in apartments, in my experience, are always really shallow. I don't even think that this giant one would actually fit in any of the cabinets, so I just leave them out, and it kind of works with the color scheme that I've chosen for the apartment. So I've got all my cooking stuff, which I'm sure will look familiar to a lot of you, my Smeg appliances, which I love. I got these cute new towels. I got a few things throughout the apartment that are from businesses that use artists' graphic designs and prints on homeware, so things like bath mats, towels, placemats. I think it's a really neat way to support artists through supporting a small business and getting something practical, because we all need dish towels. So these ones are really pretty. They have these Pacific Northwest mountains on it, which I think are gorgeous. I like having things on my counter, but I also try to keep lots of space available for chopping and cooking. I've got my Tahitian shells here. You'll see little nods to my jewelry design business throughout the apartment. So these are actually from French Polynesia when I was over there visiting pearl farms for my line. This one is actually from Moria. And what's really neat is that this one has been polished and carved, and you can see how shiny it is. And this is the luster that goes on to the pearls over a multi-year process. And this is just a complete raw one that hasn't been touched or polished at all. So I think that's kind of neat to see that contrast. And I leave these here. Maybe, you know, I'm wearing some jewelry while I'm cooking and I want to put it somewhere. That is what those are kind of useful for. And then just going back to the entrance, I have this really cute moment on this rather large wall. And again, I really wanted to keep it very open feeling. So I purchased this mirror from Jungalow, which is such a cool business that's very eco-friendly. Everything she sells is made by artisans and has a really eco-friendly focus, and I love how it turned out in the apartment. It kind of really adds a nice amount of light here. It's nice to be able to, you know, check your face before you go out. I'm short without heels, but of course normally I would be this tall, which is enough to make sure that, you know, my jewelry is on properly and my mask is properly adjusted. I always keep a clean mask ready to go here as well. Some sunglasses and my keys, because the doors here automatically lock and I know someday I'm gonna lock myself out, so that's like a reminder. I think that's about all I have to say for the kitchen area. Whenever you walk in, there's usually at least one feline, if not two, to greet you. And Sammy is in her favorite spot, but we'll come back to that a little bit later. That is one of my favorite areas of the apartment. But right now, let me take you through into the dining area, which I am so happy with. So these chairs are actually light gray, but because I'm by the water, there's always a nice kind of cool blue tone to the light, and I think they end up looking kind of blue gray. Hydrangeas are my favorite, nod to Gossip Girl perhaps, and so I've been really enjoying having some fresh cut flowers essentially smack in the middle of the room so they can be seen from everywhere, and I really enjoy having that, along with having a fair number of plants. So I have a succulent here that my cats are slowly murdering. They like to kind of paw at the little individual leaves. For all you fur parents out there, it's really about making them happy in their home. This is their place and we just live in it, right? So right below that, I also have my cat feeding area with their water fountain and food supply. And then over here, this is actually a plumeria plant that I got from Trader Joe's. I think they still have them right now. So someday if I do a good job and I'm not a plant murderer, it will have white flowers that smell like Hawaii. I'm very much missing being in Hawaii with my mom, so this is just a really nice, I don't know, way to have that around. This, I have my new fur brush. So it's the niftiest little gadget, and if you get velvet furniture, which is really perfect if you have pets, it really brushes off all the fur in one fell swoop. So I'm really happy with these chairs. I love the seashell like back of them. You can see if I can give you a little bit of a better view. And they are very hardy, very easy to clean. I just use that brush to sweep off, you know, any cat fur like this that BB leaves, because this is one of her favorite places to sit. That was my big thing that I wanted, is I wanted dining chairs that would look stylish, kind of art deco, but still be very, very comfortable. So I'm really pleased with them and pleased with how they look with my antique table. So a few of the older pieces of furniture that I have, like the coat rack and this and my mirror, are all from Belgium. They're antiques that came over with my family when we immigrated, and my mom has kindly given them to me. The chairs that go with this table need to be reupholstered, so in a future home, I might use these chairs in a different place and then use the antique chairs that go with it. But I didn't want to reupholster yet because it's, I think, a set of 8 chairs, so I didn't need that many in this space. 4 is perfect, I think, and probably won't be entertaining much larger groups than that, especially with social distancing, anytime soon. So it's pretty perfect. The table does open up though, so that you can sit more people. I do often use this area to work as well, for laptop work mainly, because I do like to maintain my other desk area for creative work only. So I'll take you to see that in a moment. But before that, this I don't think needs much discussion because I've pretty much had this set up more or less the same way in every apartment that I've been in. So this is a mid-century modern dresser. I keep a lot of my pearls and jewelry supplies in here. Has very spacious drawers, which I love. And I just really like the contrast between Art Deco, antique, and then this kind of mid-century modern vibe. I really like combining different textures and stylistic eras, or whatever you want to call it. I think it makes an apartment feel very homey rather than, you know, more formally decorated. So over here I have a gallery wall that is not finished by any means. I definitely want to add to it over time, even get some new frames potentially as well, but I have some photos of my dear friends in Vancouver and my mom and my grandmother over here, as well as Lady and Fufu, if you guys remember Fufu, if you've been watching my channel for a while. He's looking down from cat heaven and disapproving of Madame being on the table where she knows she's not supposed to be. So yes, you may sit on your velvet throne. So I keep some books there as well, which is a nice combination of different topics between law and fashion, but very reflective of my interests as well. Did choose to section off the living room area rather than have the couch against a wall. It essentially meant that a TV doesn't really make sense anywhere, and I don't mind that. I just watch TV on my laptop. I know a lot of you guys find that weird, but I don't really watch that much television unless I'm making orders or creating something as background noise, so I don't really need a TV for that purpose. A laptop is perfect. So over here I have my article couch, which has survived many a move and still looks wonderful. I'm so happy with it. It's so comfortable and so pet friendly because little scuffs from claws, you know, don't really show up, and the cats don't really scratch leather ever. It's at that buttery, smushy stage that I love. I will list the small business that I got my Washington pillow from because I think it's really cute, and it's also very easily washable. So sometimes I smush my face into it in the evenings with makeup and it's nicely washable, which the other ones, these fancier ones that I got from The Cross in Vancouver, definitely aren't. So it's a nice contrast of textures, I think, between sparkly kind of tassels, more like kind of earthy jute fabric, and this really pretty super premium velvet one that used to be more pink, but I think it's gotten a little bit bleached by the sun and now it's more of like a creamy blush color. And so over here I have my outfit of the day mirror. So I need to start doing more outfit posts, I think. I don't know if you guys would like to see that maybe on Instagram, in Insta stories. That's kind of how I used to do it. I love the background that is behind me. I feel like it has a little bit of Vancouver. It has some greenery. You can see my new beautiful rug, which I am so in love with, and I will list the seller for this rug down below because I did so much research to find a rug that had really beautiful pastel colors, wasn't over $1,000, and was going to be natural fibers. So I also have a seller that I found for much cheaper rugs that aren't natural fibers that are really beautiful, and I strongly considered getting one from there, but in the end I decided I wanted to get natural fibers because that is just kind of what I lean towards, and I'm so pleased with how it turned out. I think the pattern on it is beautiful. It really plays up a lot of these gray blue tones that I've kind of gone with the apartment, with little touches of teal or neutral colors as well. So over here in the corner, I have one side that's more industrial. I have this app on my phone that connects to a plug and it allows me to turn the light on and off, which is amazing. And you can do that remotely as well, which is pretty awesome. And it also does the same thing for my desk lights. This is where the Nouveau Pearl magic happens. This desk has always come with me. I love the glass top and that I'm able to put a measuring tape underneath it so that I don't have to fiddle with one. It's just there flat. It makes it very easy for jewelry making. If any of you guys are into that, I find that just really nifty. I have my label printer, which I love, and then my jewelry tray. I have a bunch of these that I switch out and they're always a mess because there is something that is always in progress. Here I have some Anjou earrings that are waiting to go out in Darkwing Indigo and Aurora, and just my tools. I didn't fully, you know, clean this off because in real life it never is perfectly clear. Most workbenches aren't, but I've tried to make it really aesthetically pleasing even when it is messy. So I have this pretty geode bookend set that holds my cards that I include with every order. This is actually a little sneak peek. I feel like I should pixelate it or something, but it is for a future launch and I'm very excited about it. You guys will hear more about that in another video. Over here I have my packaging for my gold line for Nouveau Pearl, some more thank you cards, and then I've got some trays over there with gemstones and various materials as well that I reach for often. There were two main finishing touches that I was waiting for in order to do this home tour, and this fiddle leaf fig tree is one of them, and its pot as well, which is enormous. I have lots of room to grow into, and it actually needs to be repotted along with the plumeria plant, but I've ordered some fancy soil that is taking a while to arrive, so that's still on my to-do list. Over here I have my slippers, which also function as a door stopper. And oh, I don't think I mentioned my little lanterns, which are from Walmart and Target respectively. Outside here, the sun is coming out for you guys, which is wonderful. Waiting for my outdoor sofa to arrive, which has been so delayed that it is definitely not worth waiting for to do this tour. So I'll do something updated, maybe a vlog showing you the end result for my little patio. But I'm so happy I get to show you this view with this beautiful sunshine. I absolutely love it. And I do love coming out here even now with no seating area. I'll just sit on the cushion with my coffee in the morning and it's pretty glorious. And over here in the corner, I did get a new plant pot as well as this pretty little shrub that to me looks like a little mini Christmas tree. There are a lot of birds in the courtyard, so the cats love to sit over here in between my two lanterns from Walmart and Target and just look out at the view and meow at the birds. Those are some of their favorite things to do. Oh look, there's even a seaplane taking off for you. I love watching that. It only happens a couple of times a day because I think the schedule is highly reduced. And it really makes me feel at home because I used to live in Cole Harbour in Vancouver where I would watch the same thing. By the way, if you're looking for some affordable little coffee tables, well hello. And are we being good furry tour guides? I think so. Aww, cuteness. You're wondering why I have a furry blanket in the middle of the summer. Bibi loves having a fuzzy blanket and I love having a blanket to curl up with as well. So that one is from UGG and I think it's my favorite blanket that I've ever had. You guys are looking for affordable side tables or coffee tables. Live edge wood is normally so expensive, but these are really, really well priced. And on it, I have my holographic Anthurium Overose candle, which is probably my favorite new luxury scent. I haven't done anything too crazy with the bar cart, but it does have some of my favorite things on it. Another Overose candle, my piggy banks from when I was a baby. Got this beautiful looking Earl Grey gin on it, which was a recent gift from a friend. So this area in between the bathroom and bedroom, I didn't know what to do with at first, and I'm so happy that I ended up putting these things here because the end result is both Sammy's favorite place to sleep and then aesthetically one of my favorite areas of the apartment too. So I've got a vintage trunk, I got this cushion made to go on top of it, and it actually used to be my dining bench in my previous apartment, which I think is a nice sign of how you can so easily repurpose things that you love in different ways in new spaces. The cushion is really old. I think it's West Elm, but I'm not even 100% sure. Wasn't properly packed when it came over from Canada, but it is still beautiful. I think it's very Snow White-esque. Turning into the bathroom, it's pretty basic. It does have a wonderful bathtub that I have loved to take soaks in. I did want it to be a little bit colorful, so I got this beautiful sunset shower curtain from Society 6. So again, these are artist prints that are used on various different things for your home. And I absolutely love how it turned out. And then I did splurge on some Missoni towels, so I absolutely love that. So I do all of my skincare in here, but I don't do my makeup in here because the lighting is just way too yellowy to work for me. So I have this little caddy which has all of my favorite scents and skincare that I reach for. And then I've realized moving into this apartment that I apparently collect robes because I have them everywhere on the back of each door. And the little bath mat that sits in front of the sink is also from Society 6. And it's actually different artists, which I think is kind of neat because they go so well together in terms of coloring. So now I'd like to take you into my bedroom, and I actually think it's a tie between my dining area and the bedroom as to which area of the apartment is my favorite. I think it might be the bedroom because it is actually the most colorful bedroom I've had since I was like a kid living in my mom's house. I do think of it as the blue room because it's got a lot of blue in it. I think many of you will remember this scarf that I had framed. It's from Cartier and it was my grandmother's scarf, and it's always been very meaningful to me because it has pearls on it, which has always felt almost like a kind of premonition. So I absolutely love the colors of it as well. And when I saw this chair, which is from the same seller as my dining chair, I truly had no purpose for it, but I had to have it because it looks even more like a seashell than the dining chairs that I purchased. And I absolutely love the color of it. It's like a true blue-gray. It's just so pretty. And my cats also like to sit there. And most mornings when I wake up over here, my cats are sitting there watching me and waiting for their breakfast, which I think is actually pretty cute. And then this is really what I was waiting for to show you in this apartment tour, because this vanity was so damaged in the move from Canada that I even considered just putting it in storage or getting rid of it because the marble top of it was completely smashed. And then there was a lift to the mirror as well that I cannot find, which doesn't mean that it's permanently lost. It might just be in a box that I haven't taken into the apartment. I love it so much that I did decide to have a custom made granite top to go on top of it, which was super pricey and complicated to find someone who would do such a small project, because most of them only want to redo, you know, your whole kitchen and they don't want to do an individual slab. But I did find Granite Marble Washington in Kent, and they had this slab which they cut down for me, but it was already pretty much the perfect size with this beautiful blue spot in the middle, which I guess some people might consider an imperfection because the rest of it is more gray tones, but to me it's perfection. I love looking at this while I get ready. It makes me think of like an embedded kind of gemstone. I just love it. So over here I've got my jewelry box from Pottery Barn, which I love, and I've got my simple human mirror that lights up that I just place on top of it because that makes it the perfect height to get ready with. And then I just have my essential makeup in here. I don't know if you guys would want to see a makeup collection video, but everything is pretty pared down nowadays because I know what I like for makeup. I try new things occasionally, usually twice a year when the Sephora sales happen, but other than that, I am pretty much a confirmed kind of neutrals lover, and I often repurchase a lot of the same things over and over.
I think something that I've grown into more and more over time is that for a place to feel beautiful and homey, things don't necessarily need to match. So you can see the wood tones on my dresser don't match my bed at all, but I really don't mind that. I think it makes a room more interesting to have different tones in it. So it's much more of a warm tone. And then my bedside table and bed are both from Restoration Hardware Outlet. I absolutely love them, but they're more of a cool tone than I think I would normally reach for. I also got this rug as a bit of an impulse purchase with my purchase of my living area rug. And I actually think it's my favorite rug that I've ever purchased because the colors in it are just like a beautiful jewel tone rainbow, and I actually love the black background and how it adds just a really nice depth and richness to this space. All of that said about its aesthetics, its real like winning factor is the fact that it is the softest rug I have ever put my feet on, and I'm always barefoot in my home because it's actually 100% silk. So it's so soft, and in a way I think that silk element, because I do 30% silk in my Nouvelle Apparel scarves to make them softer and less likely to pill than if they were 100% cashmere. I think it's like a little bit of a nod to that, which I really enjoy waking up to every single day. So let me take you into my little mini walk-in closet here, but this is still a work in progress because I'm still looking for an ideal storage solution for all of my cashmere, which, unlike my Nespresso coffee maker, did survive the storage and move, and nothing had any holes in it that I've noticed. So I am so pleased with that. I'm still figuring out how to best use this space, but for summertime, for now, this is what I've done. I've put all of my jeans here, all of my skirts and trousers down here. Over here, I've got my beloved handbag collection. I usually keep everything in dust bags, so it doesn't really look like much. I definitely have a few handbags that you guys don't know much about, but it's felt a little bit, I don't know, out of sorts, I guess, given current times, to do an updated handbag collection. If you guys want to see that and you understand where that's coming from, that it's something light and that's meant to be for people who love handbags, then I might do an updated collection in the future. Let me know in the comments down below. But essentially three sections of my closet are taken up by my handbags, which is a lot. I love summer dresses. So over here, I have my summer dress section, and that's really where I'm often getting dressed from in the morning. I often reach for a little blazer to top those off with. So those are all up there. Silk shirts, plaid shirts are over here in the section down below. And then over here in this really overly stuffed section, I have all of my more formal work dresses, which I'm not really wearing much to work from home, but I'm sure I'll want again in the future. And then over here, I've got all of my cocktail dresses. This is super messy. It's a little bin of more summery lightweight sweaters, like silk sweaters and cotton sweaters, that I had to bring down because I was cold. And then down below, I have all of my shoes. These tend to be my more dressy shoes, and the shoes I reach for every day to go for walks or run errands are in the front little closet / den area, whatever you want to call it. 3, 2, 1. So it looks like someone installed herself while I was showing you guys around. These two are like shadows of each other. Where one goes, the other is never too far behind. And I think she would confirm that even though frette sheets are ridiculously expensive, they are pretty wonderful. So this is a new set that I bought when I was in my furnished apartment and not feeling like super at home there. And it really did help to make it feel more like my bed. So Sammy has now made this her bed. Behind the door, I've installed some easy hooks that just go over the door for things that I want to reach for easily. And the robe collection does continue. So this must be like number 7 or something, which is silly, but it matches this room perfectly. And I think it's the nicest robe fabric wise that I've ever had. From Yumi Kim, designed the top that I'm wearing, and she's been one of my favorite designers recently. So come on into my ugly room. This room is not meant to be aesthetically pleasing, but somehow I think it actually kind of ended up being pretty nice largely thanks to this industrial looking clothing rack, which is actually on wheels. So if I ever wanted to have that kind of on display, have some clothing on display in my room, for example, it's, I think, really useful, and it's really nice. It's solid wood planks. It was a nightmare to put together, but I think it really kind of made this room a lot more functional than I ever thought it would be. So I have some more cardigans and things up there on the top, coats that I've been reaching for hikes and things like that over here. And then I just have useful things. This is my lady toolkit, so it doesn't look very nice, but it has all of my hanging equipment and bits and pieces from vacuums and things like that. My dining chairs actually came with a dust cover, so I've kept them for a future move to protect them. And then down below here are the shoes, kind of walking shoes, that I reach for the most often. These Cole Haan ones, if you're looking for some summer sandals, are so comfy. I got these little slides from Sam Edelman. I did get a pair of Rothy's, and I do really like them. I think they're made from recycled plastic bottles or something cool like that. And then I've got my Cupcakes in Cashmere sandals, which I love. And if you've never experienced Sperry boat shoes, they're some of my favorite shoes to wear on long walks. The back, I somehow magically did fit all of my coats, which I never thought I would be able to. They are kind of crammed in there, so as I use them more, I could see myself hanging them over here for easy reach. But for now, they're all pretty heavy fall and winter clothes, so they can stay over there. And then up there, I just have my scarves. If you guys can see, I've got my good old orchid scarf there from my previous collection. A yoga mat that I don't use nearly enough. This isn't perfect. I think for the long run, I do need to get a lingerie chest or something for linens. The problem is I kind of like one that matches my bed and bedside table potentially, or something that complements them, and I just haven't found that yet. So for now, my sheets and things like that are living in these Tupperware containers, which is fine. And then, not very glamorous, but if any of you have pets and you don't want to buy a Dyson, you don't want to get something super expensive, this vacuum is kind of amazing in terms of how powerful it is. You can see all the cat fur disgusting stuff it's sucked up. So it works really, really well, and I'm really pleased with it.
So that is my apartment tour. It was so nice to have you all over. Thank you for joining me. And you'll see more of it and its developments in my next videos on style. So if you'd like to see that, make sure you give this video a like and subscribe. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.